Good day, everyone. I've heard the word youth many times here, but still, I don't think I can fully grasp its true meaning. I have searched the dictionary, and the best definition I managed to find is this, and I quote, "Youth is the condition of being young, the appearance, freshness, vigor, and spirit of one who is young." But I feel as if this is not enough. I think this particular theme requires a more philosophical approach. And what better way to understand the philosophical way of thinking of a person than to ask that person about wisdom? And even more, what better way to understand the philosophical way of thinking of a young person than to ask that young person about wisdom in youth? It's clear then, we must try and speak as philosophers would. Well, I'll try, I really will. But I don't think I'll be able to do it very well because it might be going a little bit against what I'm actually trying to prove in this speech. And that is the simple fact that we cannot have everything we want to have, do anything we want to do, and be anyone we want to be at any age. In other words, if we consider that we can have everything we want to have, do anything we want to do, and be everyone we want to be with the person that we are now, then we have to face it. We do not want enough. But still, I will share with you my understanding of the word youth. I think it's something one unavoidably loses whilst progressing in life. If one loses something by progressing, one also expects to gain something in return, something at least as valuable as that which is what he or she has lost. Otherwise, you couldn't call it progress, could you? So, what does one get back from life? What does one gain that is comparable with youth? Experience, of course, and knowledge. And do you know what these two very important things provide? They provide wisdom. They mean wisdom. Therefore, we can agree right here and now that there exists a very real but somewhat philosophical connection between youth and wisdom. You lose one and gain the other in life, especially as we know it today. You get wiser by getting older. You get wisdom by losing youth. Therefore, a question arises, and this, I think, as boring as it may seem to some of you, is the absolute climax of the theme we were given to discuss. Is wisdom compatible with youth, or can we safely say that youth cannot possess wisdom in any way? Now, this is a good question. It's a very good question. But in order to answer this question, I feel as if I also have to define the word wisdom. And again, I will be using my own philosophical approach. In my opinion, wisdom is the ability to face anything your world can throw at you and conquer it, using means and methods based on carefully structured principles. But at the same time, wisdom represents the very important realization within each and every one of us that no matter how much we know, we can always know more. A wise person is perfectly aware at all times that in order to give his or her life meaning, any meaning at all, he or she must continue growing indefinitely. And this is not as easy as it may sound. Ask us teenagers, for example. Growing is a natural part of life, at least up until we reach 18. That's when growing really starts to take effort. And here's why. The reason is very simple. This is the age at which we normally start to ask ourselves questions, difficult questions, but important ones nonetheless, with an equally important purpose: to lay the basis of our understanding of the world around us. And this is not something you want to get wrong, because the only way to become wise is to gather knowledge. And the only way to gather knowledge is to ask questions. Now, the problem lies in the fact that the opportunities to answer each of these questions fly by us very quickly. And once we've asked a question, regardless of the answer we received, we cannot ask the same question again. And the reason is very simple. What makes us ask these questions in the first place, apart from our very peculiar age, are the experiences we go through in our lives, which constantly overwhelm us with new things to ask about. Therefore, if we fail to answer one of these questions and linger upon it for too long, we will not only be losing time, but we will also be losing opportunities to answer other questions, which might in turn be even more important than the first question we failed to answer. The more questions we fail to answer, the more time it takes us to gather knowledge. And the more time it takes us to gather this knowledge, the more time it takes us to become wise. And I hope you all agree with me. Youth does not care about time. It forsakes you, and you don't even know about it. So, taking all of this in consideration, it's clear that although youth cannot possess the wisdom one gathers in a lifetime of experiences, it does, however, possess an even more important kind of wisdom. The wisdom to start experiencing. There is no end without beginning. We are that beginning. Thank you.